Hello, the overview of Joel, which is a three chapter short book. The message in Joel sees the massive locust plague and severe drought devastating Judah as a harbinger of the great and dreadful day of the Lord. That's in chapter 2, verse 31. The locusts he mentions in 1 and 4 and 2 and 25 of this book are best understood as real insects, not as a layer allegorical, I'm sorry, representations of the Babylonians, Medo-Persians, Greeks, and Romans, as held by some interpreters. Confronted with this crisis, he calls on everyone to repent, old and young, drunkards, farmers, and priests. He describes the locusts as the Lord's army and sees in their coming a reminder that the day of the Lord is near. He does not voice the popular notion that the day will be one of judgment on the nations, but deliverance and blessing for Israel. Instead, with Isaiah 2:10 through 21, Jeremiah 4:5 through 9, Amos 5:18 through 20, and Zephaniah 1:7 through 18, he describes the day as one of punishment of unfaithful Israel as well. Restoration and blessing will come only after, and I repeat, only after judgment and repentance. And if you read the, if you look at the book that gives you the title, the first chapter through the second starts talking about Judah experience a foretaste of the day of the Lord, a call of mourning and prayer, the announcement of the day of the Lord, a call of repentance and prayer. Judah is assured of salvation in the day of the Lord, the Lord's restoration of Judah, the Lord's renewal of his people, and the coming of the day of the Lord, the nations judged and God's people blessed. Amen.